Hey guys, look what I got. That's right, I got the new E-flite Pitts S1S. This is the big brother to, younger big brother, to the UMX Pitts. It will fly on 3 and 4S, 1800 to 2200 milliamp hour LiPos, but I'm gonna quit talking. We're gonna open up the box and we're gonna see what's going on inside. All right guys, here's everything that comes inside the box, or at least this is how it's packaged. You can see right there in the middle, we've got the fuse, awesome, top and bottom. We've got the main wings, right down there. We got the horizontal stab, prop stuff, right there. Those are those elusive wing struts some people haven't been able to find in the box. That's where they're at, guys. At least that's how it came packaged inside my box. I'm literally just looking at it right now with you guys, so that's cool. If you look right back there, that's where the wheel pants are. So coming up next, we are going to take this outside of the package and we're going to look at everything all laid out, guys. All right, guys, here are all the parts and pieces that come inside the box. As you can see, there are quite a few different pieces here. There's several different layers. We've got the horizontal stab right there, which we have to glue into the fuse right there. Not a big deal. You can use your CA. I might use foam tack. We'll see. Not entirely positive what I'm going to do, but the kit itself looks terrific. The texture seems nice and smooth and sleek. You don't have any gatoring, any bumps or anything like that, so that's cool. The prop is solid, 11x7. Everything just seems great. The landing gear really seems solid. So what I'm going to do is I'm going to put this thing together. And I'm gonna let you know if I have any little snags along the way. And hopefully, fingers crossed, the next thing you see is this plane all put together. All right, guys, here's what everything looks like all put together. As you can see, this is a beautiful plane. I'm really excited about that. Of course, there are certain things that were a little bit quirky with this build process, and I'm gonna kind of go over those. So, one thing that you're gonna need is a 2mm Allen wrench instead of your standard Phillips screwdriver heads. You need Allen wrench heads or hex heads, and they're of the 2mm variety. Now the landing gear was super easy to install. They weren't self-tapping screws, but they were machine screws and they screwed in. They were so quick and easy. I had those on put together nice and solid in probably about 30 to 40 seconds. It was that flipping easy. And by the way, the landing gear in the front there is so solid, it'll blow your flipping mind. So know that, appreciate that, that's great. Now the tail section, not too terribly complicated, but I had a little bit of an issue with the glue. I got it stuck to my finger and I pulled it off and ripped off a little bit of paint. Luckily, I had a little paint left over from my BAE Hawk when I added some mesh to the cheater holes, and that did a decent enough job. Of course, it was on the underside, so it didn't have to be perfect, so that's cool. Everything is all good there. The main wing assembly, that was pretty tricky, I must say. The bottom wing, the pin that fits on the bottom, the plastic didn't line up perfectly. In fact, it was raised up a little higher than it needed to be, so you have to do a little bit of wiggling. In fact, the whole installation on the main wing, the whole thing you need to keep in mind is staying patient and doing some wiggling back and forth to get the stuff to slide in. If you do that, you keep it cool, it'll be just fine. It won't be a big deal at all. But if you get stressed, try and force things, then you may have some problems. And that's not good. We don't want any problems. So as far as the prop assembly goes, that was a little bit weird. Nothing matched up with what was going on with the manual. And pretty much just go by how you think it's going to go, because it's pretty simple. If you overthink it, you're going to have problems. Keep it simple. And of course, if you have questions, please ask them in the comments. I'm happy to help out as much as I possibly can in the comment section. That is definitely something I like to do. So bring those questions. I really do want to help you guys out. All right, coming up next, I'm gonna show you the battery that I'm gonna use, as well as the radio setup. All right, guys, here's a look inside the battery bay. Right back there, that is where the battery sits. I'm gonna take that out here shortly, and we're gonna take a closer look at that. And of course, right down there, we've got our elevator and rudder servos. And right there in the center, we have our XT60 adapter for the EC3 connector coming off the ESC. And then right here, we've got our XT60 plug for the battery. All right, coming up next, I'm gonna pull that thing out. We'll take a closer look. All right, guys, here is a look at the battery tray. We've got Velcro, two straps of that to hold it down. And frankly, it holds it down really tight. You may wanna add some Velcro to the bottom of the battery as well as placing it on the top of this battery tray. You don't need to. As you can see, I mean, I'm really jerking it hard and it's just fine. We've got these little rails here that this slides into. This is where you put your finger in there and you slide it back in there. It will clip in, you'll hear a sound. You've got these little plastic pieces right there. And you've got these rails top and bottom. So it's actually a pretty secure little piece, pretty smart design. And it gives you flexibility for the different batteries you want to use. And speaking of flexibility, the center of gravity has a pretty wide range according to Horizon Hobby. Originally in the manual, they say 86 millimeters is the nice center of gravity point. Most recently on RC Groups, one of their reps commented that 70 is now the recommended center of gravity. So pretty much anywhere between 86 millimeters and 70 millimeters is the recommended CG. Now, if you look at a biplane like this, with the UMX Pitts, I could put the battery pretty much anywhere in the battery bay and it would fly great. So that actually makes sense. Now, the farther you put it back, the more acrobatic it's gonna be. If you want it to be able to handle wind a little bit better, you put it a little bit farther forward. So kind of experiment with that. None of it should be the end of the world as long as it is within that 86 to 70 millimeter CG range. Coming up next, we've got some more fun. All right, guys. So one thing I get asked all the time is which packs do I use in different planes? So in this plane, I plan on using this 4S 1875C pack. It's a Scorpion competition power pack, and I've used these in a variety of other planes. I've got several of these different packs in 3 and 4S, and I really like them. So I think, and especially based on just my testing, I did a little prop test off camera, and I blew the canopy that was sitting off to the side. It bounced off the friggin' wall. So this thing is gonna give me lots of thrust, lots of power, and it should make the maiden very exciting. Okay guys, now we're gonna talk about the radio setup. Essentially, it is really easy. Just follow the basic steps laid out in the manual and you'll have no problems at all. Essentially, the manual recommends for ailerons and all the control services, 70% on low rates and 100% on high rates. Now, I went with 70 and 90, and I always do 30% expo just to give me a little extra cushion, just in case it's a little too touchy for me. I can always adjust from there, go on high rates or low rates. It'll be up to me in that kind of scenario, so I like that. Coming up next, we're gonna talk about SAFE. Okay, so now we're gonna talk about SAFE, SAFE Select, that is. If you wanna select SAFE, when you bind the radio, you plug in the battery and wait for the light to flash on the receiver. Then you pull that plug, then you turn it on, holding down the bind button, and you bind it. Now, I do not have the bind plug in that, nor do I have the battery plugged into the plane right now. So I've already got it set up with Safe Select. So let's say you have everything set, you already did that process I just mentioned, and then you want to select a switch to put Safe Select on, put your safe on. You hold in these sticks like so, and then you flip the switch up and down 5 times for a complete cycle. And then there you go, it's set. It's that simple. And the top range will have the safe. Definitely test that on yours just to verify, but that's how it's always gone with mine. So that would be safe is on if the A switch is up, and if it's down, then it's off. But of course, to test it, you pick up the plane physically and move it back and forth, and it will indicate whether that's on or off. So definitely test that. Don't just rest on your laurels. And coming up next, we are actually gonna plug in the plane, connect it to the radio, and move some control surfaces. Okay, so here we're gonna do a quick little control surfaces demo. Now these are all, I'm just moving all the control surfaces here. These are all on low rates. Now I'm gonna jack these up to 90%, which is my high rate setting. Still not a ton of movement on the rudder. A little bit more on the elevator there. And then we've got 4 of those going, 2 on each side for the aileron. So it really doesn't need a ton of movement to have lots of responsiveness. So there you go. Coming up next, we're gonna do our review notes wrap up. All right, guys, even though I probably shouldn't, I am gonna do a motor test here before we do our review notes wrap up. Now, it's pretty late when I'm doing this right now, so I'm not gonna crank it up way up. Also, keep in mind, this is 4S and it's ridiculously powerful. A little bit earlier on, I had that canopy sitting on the bed and I gave it a quick test and it blew it clean across the bed against the wall. So this thing has a lot of power on 4S, let me tell you that much. So here's a little taste of that. Holy cow, I barely gave it anything and it was tugging pretty hard. So that's a little taste, guys. Coming up next is the review notes wrap up. All right, guys, we're gonna do our review notes wrap up here. We're gonna start with the pros and end with the cons. As far as the pros go, this thing, as you can see, is beautiful. I love the red, I love the white. Everything about this aesthetically, I really like. Wouldn't be the worst thing in the world to have some stickers, some white stickers on the wheel pants to really round out the scale finish. But even without that, this thing is beautiful. Another big pro is this will fly on either 3 or 4S. That means that you can tailor it to your mood. It just gives you tons of flexibility, and I really, really like that. Another huge pro is that it comes with AS3X, which has been around for a while, so it's not like groundbreaking or anything, but you've also got the SAFE Select, which is relatively new on planes like this, and something that I have found to be very handy. Let's say you get disoriented, you fly into the sun, kind of lose track of where the plane's at, flip the switch, SAFE Select, or turn it into SAFE, level yourself out, hopefully get out of the glare of the sun, boom. As soon as your eyes refocus, you're in control of the plane, flip it out of SAFE, you're on flying exactly how you wanted to and were before. So it can come in handy in a multitude of scenarios, so don't underestimate how valuable that can be. The next big pro is the landing gear. Structurally, it's beautiful, it's got rubber tires, it's got aluminum structure, it looks great, it goes together super easy, and that's the main landing gear, and then the tail section is really solid. A lot of my tail draggers lately from Horizon Hobby have been sloppy. This is rock solid, so awesome. Now, as far as the cons go, I do want to be completely blunt. The build has some quirks. None of it's the end of the world, but it's good to know that. One, the manual does not match up with all the parts and pieces, so expect that. If you expect it, it's not a big deal. And that applies particularly to the prop assembly. So, you know, like I said earlier in the video, just ask me questions in the comments section and I'm happy to help you out, help you walk through that. We'll talk about it on my GB Linden's RC Facebook page. Just message me on there. I'll send you pictures. I will help you out in any way that I can, guys. I really do take this role that I have seriously, and I want to help every one of you guys out. Have awesome flights, have fun. That's what this thing is all about for me. That's why I put in the extra time and everything that I do here. It's like midnight or 1 o'clock in the morning on a Friday night. So that's why I do what I do. All right, so the assembling the main wing also takes a little bit longer than you think. So we've got these little pins right here. You have to be super patient with those. You have to bend the pin a little bit to get the angle just right. There's a lot of finesse involved with that, getting that just right. Just be patient, everything will work out. The final thing I mentioned a little bit ago is the CG. It's a little bit different than what the manual says, so pay attention to the latest reports. Even call Horizon Hobby, ask them. If you're really not sure what you want to do with that, don't take my word 100% for it, because I haven't flown it yet. After I do post the maiden flight, please ask me and I will be able to corroborate either way. With all that being said, like, comment, and subscribe. And GB Linden.